Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to another Android Studio tutorial, and today I will show you something different from what we have learned before. So today we are going to learn about the basic activity in Android Studio. So for the past 14 tutorials we were using the empty activity, which is going to be the first activity shown in the Android Studio, and now we have almost every basics of how to create an Android application. So now we are going to move into a little advanced level of Android programming. So first of all, you have to open the Android Studio, and from the Android Studio I'm going to create a new project, and I just want to name the project as basic activity. You can give it as any name as you wish, and we have discussed about using all of the things in Android Studio. Let's go to the next page. Next, and here you can see in the first tutorial we have used the empty activity, and today we are going to learn about the basic activity, which is going to be this one. So in the basic activity you will be getting menu button, and you will also get a floating action button in the activity. So let's go with the basic activity. I have selected this one. Now click on the next and next, and now it's building the basic activity project in the Android Studio. So we have to wait a couple seconds, so I'm going to skip this setup. Okay guys, now we have the basic activity completely loaded, and here we can see it is almost similar to the empty activity, and the only difference is that now we have the activity underscore main.xml and a content main.xml. The difference between these two is that the content main is the place that we're gonna add the text view, then web view, button, and many other things, and the activity underscore main.xml is the background for this content main XML. Now I'm in the content main.xml, and now let's go to the text, and we have seen everything is similar as the empty activity, but in the empty activity we have seen these codes inside the activity underscore main.xml, but in this basic activity we have all the codes from the activity underscore main.xml in the content main.xml. So let's go to the activity main.xml, and now we have seen here is a sum of couple of items. So basically it uses the coordinator layout, and inside that we have app bar layout and the toolbar, which is going to be this one, action bar, and inside that we have the include, which is going to be the activity area, and now finally we have the fab, which is a new guy into our Android application development, that is floating action button. Here you can see that this thing is called as floating action button. It is nothing but a button that uses the material design with a shadow effect. When the user click it, it can able to change its position and like that. So let's go, now we have the activity underscore main.xml. Let's go to the text, and here we can see we have the coordinate layout and some other things. Let's turn on the preview. Okay, so we have the toolbar, which is inside this app bar layout, and inside that we have seen here is a code that says include layout, then content underscore main.xml. Actually the activity underscore main.xml is using content main.xml as its background and the activity area, and all of the things comes to be working under the content main. So we are going to add each and every items, widgets, many views, and many other things inside the content main, and the activity underscore main.xml is not the area that we're gonna be going to edit in the future development of this application, that is basic activity. Okay, so now let's go to the main activity.java, and we have seen there are a lot of other new lines added. So in the empty activity we have only seen up to the set content view, and after that it closes with these two curly braces. So now we have many other methods like one create option menu and one create one option item selector. So in the basic activity, as I have said before, we have new option, that is the menu, that we have the option to add menu items. Also here is the floating action button inside this one create method, and here is its click listener, and now here you can see this is the snack bar, which is almost similar to the toast that we have discussed in the previous lesson. So snack bar is nothing that come from the bottom that shows a message, and you can able to also add a action for that message, like a button that says something, just dismiss or take action or something like that. So here is the action that user and there is no any special action added into the snack bar. We'll be discussing that in the later tutorial. So today we are going to get the basic idea of this basic activity. And now moving to the project section, we have the new folder called menu. Inside that we have menu_main.xml. Let's open that, and we have seen here is a new menu item, which is the settings. So there is only one item at this time. This is the basic idea of how the menu work. So in the menu we have seen here is a ID, as we have seen same as the button, image views, text views, and many other things uses the ID. So normally here we have a ID with the order in category as 100, which is some kind of thing that we're gonna be using if we have more than one item. And next we have the title, which is called from the string, and here is the final thing, show as action, never. So if you change it into always, it will be going to show the action, or the menu action will be shown at this toolbar, which is the action bar. So we'll be discussing menu, snack bar, floating action button, and all other things in different tutorials. So we have almost a basic idea of how the basic activity work in Android Studio. The main thing that we have to learn in this basic activity is that we have two different kind of layouts now, which is the content-main.xml and the activity-main.xml. So once again, I'm repeating, the content main is the place that we are going to do all the stuff like adding new widgets, adding new layouts, and many other things. And the activity_main.xml is the place where we are going to add the background items like the floating action button and the toolbar and many other things. So now let's go and change the constraint and layout into relative layout. Control Alt L to reformat the codes. So now we have the text view inside this relative layout. Okay, now let's go to the design. We're gonna be adding a button into the center. Okay, so let's add another thing, text view. So everything is same as that of the empty activity, and the only difference is that now we have the floating action button and snack bar. And also the finally we have the new option, that is menu. Now we can able to also add menu into our Android application. That's it. So let's go and run it in a live device and check that out. So at the bottom we have the floating action button with the snack bar, and the top we have the menu with the settings as the item. So yeah, that's it. Thanks for watching, and if you have any kind of questions, you can ask in the comment section below this video. And stay tuned. Thanks for watching. Peace out.